Francisco Panizza of the London School of Economics.
In 2006, there was a new government in Uruguay, and the president happened to be an oncologist by profession. So, as you can imagine, one of his first initiatives was to try to bring down smoking.
Smoking was a real problem in Uruguay. A lot of people smoke.
Absolutely, a lot of people smoke, yes. So in 2008, Parliament passed a very comprehensive policy of anti-smoking legislation, which includes prohibition of smoking public places, prohibition of advertising, and Philip Morris used this investor protection treaty and sued the Uruguayan government for loss of profit. Smoking in Uruguay has come down substantially, and what struck me when I go now is how little people smoke anywhere. So, on the whole, I think the population strongly supports the legislation.
There's the threat that governments will lose their sovereignty to the multinationals unless these clauses are kept out of TTIPs.
Governments have been losing sovereignty to multinationals since the first multinational investment in a country. The question is what that multinational can bring a country in terms of jobs, technology, etc. And what is the price that governments are prepared to pay for that? The Uruguayan government has been quite successful in the last 10 years or so of attracting foreign direct investment that has strongly contributed to economic growth in Uruguay. So under the right conditions, there may be a price worth paying for securing foreign direct investment.
Francesco Panizza, a Latin American professor at the London School of Economics. Having listened from the Institute of Directors, this is a legitimate matter of public concern, isn't it?
I absolutely understand why it's a matter of public concern. And there's a couple of things that I'd like to clarify on my idea. It's not all multinational. Just under a quarter of the firms who are actually undertaking ISDS claims are small and medium-sized businesses. Secondly, ISDS was created by states for the protection of states. So the idea of undermining sovereignty in democratically nationally elected government is quite sensible because the government's the ones who actually want it. In Europe, for example, under certain bilateral investment treaties, countries like Slovakia and Poland and the Czech Republic have been sued more than anyone. And yet, these are some of the countries that wrote a letter to the Commission not too long ago saying that they absolutely, under no circumstances, wanted ISDS watered down from the trade agreement.
I don't see how ISDS is in any way justified. We've seen that decisions made by democratic governments to try to regulate their society, to try to protect public services, to try to protect the environment, have been challenged successfully by companies under these mechanisms. So I just don't see how there's any justification for that.
There is a clear need to actually try and change and reform ISDS to narrow the scope of abuse. And I think that what we shouldn't be doing is what I feel is sort of the position that Nicholas Hurling is going from effectively 60 to 0 without even talking about what you can actually change about it. And the Commission is now consulting on those areas to how you should try and have that protection of the right to regulate.
That's a great point because the Commission had a consultation. 97% of the people who responded to that consultation said they did not want ISDS. So the consultation for me is pretty clear, and how can you overturn a consultation which has that kind of a result?
The consultation has never been a binding directive on governments of what to do. It's a consultation. And all this can smack, quite frankly, of latent anti-Americanism. And I think the NSA's wider scandal has probably had quite a lot to do with that.
Absolute rubbish. The United States doesn't want it either.
This is obviously extremely complicated, and passions are roused, and all sorts of interests are involved in it. Trade talks drag on and maybe come to no conclusion. Is TTIP going to happen, Ali?
I have huge concerns, and I think that's why sort of coalition for prosperity, not just from business, but from consumers as well, needs to be built.
TTIP going to happen, Nick?
The citizens of Europe, I don't believe, want this deal. I believe it's wanted by big business, and I think it's our job, therefore, to try and stop it. But it won't be easy. There's many interests that really, really want this to happen, so it's going to be a long and arduous campaign.
TTIP is a huge and complex negotiation, and we can't possibly know what's going to be resolved and what won't be. But many thanks to my studio guests, Ali Renison of the Institute of Directors and Nick Gordon of Global Justice Now. World trade is hugely important. It would be good to know more about what's happening behind almost closed doors.
For many, the world is richer than it has ever been. We're living longer.
The life expectancy has risen by 6 years since 1990.
We're better off.
20 years. 2010. Global.